not touch man, because what that means is now, in order for them not to be killed and executed, they have to be a virgin. Okay. Why does it matter if they're a virgin, number one?
So does it say one second.
No, 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 no. You're missing the
but
point
sure,
here.
Sure,
he says,
sure,
one second.
Sir.
Uncle,
they
uncle, you might have heart
they
attack.
Had a sex.
Relax.
Sure,
one second.
Sex.
When it says,
sure,
when it says,
it doesn't say.
One second.
It
when it says, when
no,
it says,
it say.
Keep the little girls who are virgins
but Muhammad had a sex.
For yourself.
Ali, you
Muhammad
had
one second.
A sex, Ali, you
one second.
Time to
so one second. You're next. You're next. You're next. You're next, bub. You're next. Yeah, you're next.
Because you're
yeah,
the
you're next.
Yeah.
One second. One second. Well, yeah, it is. It is. No, no, no. No, no, no. No, no. They believe in the Trinity. It's one against one. So my point is this, yeah. My point is this, yeah. So what I'm trying to say, why is it that you come and say, Ali, why are you looking at this section? And you do the same thing with Aisha's marriage.
She was not even menstruated.
Yes, consummated. Nowhere in here.
One second. The Prophet married her at 6, yeah? He consummated at 9. Why did he wait 3 years?
For many reasons.
Tell me one of those.
Well, her hair fell out when he did marry.
That's BS. David, we got that from David Wood, and that's we got debunked that.
How is that BS?
We debunked that because no way in the Hadith, Bukhari.
Go and talk to them.
Watch this now.
Yeah.
Watch this.
Come on.
Tell me where you mentioned that it's in Bukhari.
Come on.
Yeah, you're gonna stop
you
it.
Both,
tell
you
me.
Both ran.
Tell me. Can
you
I,
both
can
ran
I,
away.
Can I finish?
You
can
both
I finish?
Ran away.
You're scared.
You both
yeah.
ran away.
Tell me where in Bukhari. Tell me where in Bukhari that it says that the reason why she didn't get married to the Prophet is because her hair fell out. Watch this now, watch this.
This inshallah never
You're
came.
Crapping yourself.
This inshallah never came.
They're scared, watch this.
You
remember my question?
You said inshallah we are coming to
no, no,
give
scared.
You the answer.
They're scared, they're
but
scared.
But inshallah,
and here's the question.
You never came.
June now, what did he say? He said Aisha's hair was falling out.
Yep.
I challenge you to show me anywhere in Bukhari, Muslim, Ibn Majah, Abu Dawud, that says the reason why the Aisha didn't marry the Prophet and waited 3 years is because her hair fell out.
I didn't say that's why you married her.
No, no, no. You said, I said, why did he wait 3 years? You said, because her hair was falling out. You got the argument from David Wood. We debunked him. We done a video with my teacher 2-3 years ago. So tell me where that says that Aisha was not marrying the Prophet earlier because her hair was falling out.
What was Muhammad doing during the time when Aisha?
Can you answer my question, please?
Yeah, but I'm asking you a question.
Can you answer my question?
You want me to show you the
Hadith? The Prophet, yes. Read it. You read it.
The Prophet engaged me when I was a girl of 6.
Yeah.
We went to Medina, stayed at the home of, I can't pronounce this.
Yes.
Then I got ill and my hair fell
okay.
down.
Oh. Yeah.
Later on, my hair grew.
Yes.
And my mother came to me whilst I was playing in a swing
yes.
with some of my girlfriends.
Yeah. Mm. Carry on.
Carry on.
Okay. Carry on. One
so,
second.
She called me and I went to her,
yeah.
not knowing what she wanted me to do.
Yes.
She caught me by the hand
yes.
and made me stand at the door of the house.
Yep.
I was breathless, and when my breathing became all right,
yes.
she took some water, rubbed my face.
Okay.
Then she took me into the house,
yes.
where I saw some Ansari women.
Yep.
Best wishes and Allah's blessing and good luck.
Yep.
She entrusted me to them and then prepared me for the marriage.
Okay.
Unexpectedly, Allah's apostle came to me in the forenoon and my mother handed him over to me.
Okay.
At that time, I was a girl of 9.
Okay. Where
so
in
can
that...
Can I ask you one
can
question?
Can I speak?
Can I ask you one question?
Why are you scared? 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 There you go. There you go. I thought so. Let me tell you something. Where does it say that the reason the Prophet didn't marry her was because her hair was falling?
Not yellow book of Islam.
No, one second.
Not yellow book of Islam.
One second. Now the question is this. At the age of 6, are you telling me her hair falling out to her coming back was 3 years? Where does it say that in the Hadith?
This passage is from Hadith.
No, one second.
And who's the writer? Muslim are the writer.
No, Muslim, where does it say that the Prophet
and
waited
Muslim
3 years
Muslim
because her hair was falling out?
Who are giving this
why,
information
wait
that Aisha's hair was falling?
Excuse me, because
that's
the fact that the Prophet, peace be upon him, did not marry her, he married her at 6.
Muhammad.
He could have easily said, if it's what you're claiming, he could have said, hold on a second, I'm the Prophet of God. I would like to marry her at 6 and consummate it at 6. Sorry, why did he not do that? I thought so. So now June. So now, okay, answer. Okay, I'm sorry.
So first of all, it's hard for a 50-year-old man
yeah.
to have sex with a 6-year-old
excellent,
girl.
Excellent.
Second,
yes.
when
yes.
they were married, they were moving to, I think, Mecca or Medina at that time.
Yes.
They were during war. Muhammad probably didn't have it on his mind.
Probably.
Plus
yeah.
she was bald.
Okay.
And he only consummated once her hair became here.
Mm.
And he took her off a swing to do that.
Yeah.
Are you finished?
Yeah.
Once again, Do you have any evidence?
He read the evidence. Did he read the evidence from the yellow book?
Do you have any evidence?
Did he read the
Where in the hadith does it say that the Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him, delayed the marriage because her hair was falling out? I asked a very simple question, June. Where in the hadith, any literature, even in Fatwa Bari, yeah? One second. Where it says the following, because you're saying the following, you're speculating. Because the Prophet went to war, because of da-da-da, I'm asking a simple question. Where in the hadith does it say, the Prophet of Allah, I didn't marry Aisha at six and consummated at six because her hair was falling out? Can you please bring me a single evidence? Because what you're doing now is, I went to the book of Numbers, you totally diverted it. No, you have not answered that, sir. No, you have not answered that, sir.
He has read the hadith.
So, I'm asking you again. And I'm going to stick to the hadith.
Is written by
where in the hadith does it say?
By a Muslim.
Where in the hadith does it say that the Prophet Muhammad did not marry her because her hair fell out?
I would like to throw this question back at you. Where does it say?
You can't answer a question with a question.
Where does Muhammad say he waited for Aisha to reach puberty?
Very simple. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, married her at six.
Yep.
Why could he have not consummated it at six?
It would have been hard.
Why?
He has already told you.
One second.
He has already explained.
Why?
Because 6-year-old isn't fully developed.
No, irrelevant. But your claim is, I would have been like the Prophet's a paedophile. Yeah. A paedophile doesn't say, I would have been like. By the way, most paedophiles are white middle-aged men who go to Thailand and Africa. But listen to what Muhammad say. Yes, it does.
Muhammad's a white man.
You know, I don't think you understand. The issue of paedophilia is not a Muslim issue, mate. Anyways, the point is the following, yeah? I'm saying the Prophet could have said, I am the Prophet of God, and they all obey him. He could have said, marriage at six, consummation at six. Why did he, I know you're having a panic attack. Why did he wait till 9 years old? Your claim is there was other reasons. Bring your evidence.
The first point destroyed your prophet.
What's your evidence?
The first point.
What's your evidence, June? June, what is your evidence?
When he married her, right, she was six, and they were moving to Medina.
Where's your evidence they were moving to Medina?
He was playing for 3 years.
Where's the evidence? No, one second. Where's the evidence they moved to Medina?
For 3 years, he was playing with her. He was using his penis and putting in between.
Where is your evidence that moved to Medina?
All the time.
Where is your evidence during the moved to Medina?
Shame on that prophet. Shame on that prophet. Shame on that Hijra. Prophet.
I don't know. You're telling me he was moving to Medina. Tell me when. There's not a lot of things I know. I'm asking a very simple question. Where is your evidence that they were moving to Medina and that was the cause he didn't marry her? One second. When you do Hijra, who said you can't marry when you do Hijra? Where in Islam does it say?
Is he doing Hijra?
No. Even if he was, it doesn't say you're not allowed to consummate.
You should be ashamed.
Even if they were doing Hijra, nowhere in Islam it says when you're doing Hijra, you're not allowed to marry and consummate.
Of course, yeah.
No, it doesn't. Nowhere in Islam.
Listen to me carefully.
Yeah? The point is this. Nowhere in Islam does it say that when you marry, when you're doing Hijra, marriage is forbidden. Because we know evidence that, for example, there was a guy who did Hijra for a woman.
Yes.
The point is the following.
So
you are now making speculation. Yeah?
I'm not making
you are. Now, let's make it clear to you.
You
have no evidence. You've been watching David Wood's videos. Now, if that's pedophilia,
you want to have a time debate, you can.
Your God is pedophile. Because who's the God of the Old Testament? Who's the God of the Old Testament? Jesus, right? Guys, who's the God of the Old Testament? Who?
Shame on you.
Who?
Shame on you.
All together, who's the God of the Old Testament? Who?
You should be condemned.
He's running from a time debate.
The book of Numbers, chapter 18, and save little girls for yourself. Who's that from? Jesus.
Inshallah.
So you're going to be a pedophile.
You don't have an answer for that.
So let me get this right. Guys, let me get this right, yeah? The Prophet Muhammad, I would have been like, he's a pedophile. That means your God is a pedophile.
No, your God is a pedophile.
No, your God. Because you know why? You're saying the book of Numbers is the Old Testament. The God of the Old Testament is who? Jesus. Who said Jesus? To Numbers. To Moses. Your God is a pedophile. Say bye-bye to Jesus. Say bye-bye to your God.
Where's that?
Allah. Your God.
Allah. The Torah and the gospel.
Your God.
Muslims. Yeah.
Your God, according to you.
Hold on.
And by the way, the Jesus to Isa is two separate things. So let me do this. No. So, bro, you're next. I'm going to slap you up silly, bro.
I'm right now.
I'm going to slap you up silly, like intellectually.
Come on.
I'm going to slap you intellectually. Let me finish with you. Yeah? Take a step back. You're next. Wait for your cue. Wait for your cue. Wait for your cue. Wait for your cue. Wait for your cue.
You get destroyed, bro.
Yeah? You get slapped up silly. You're going to get slapped up silly intellectually.
Why do it?
Yeah, intellectually.
Oh, intellectually, because you can't do it physically.
Yeah, why would I do it physically? Why would I do it physically? Unless you want to go outside the park, that's a different story.
Well, if you want to go outside the park,
anytime.
Let's go right now.
After no cameras.
Let's go right now. What do you mean no cameras?
No cameras.
We're right
no
here.
No cameras mean you go.
Are we not right here?
No cameras mean you go.
Yeah? Let's go.
Yeah? You know what, bro? You know what time it is, bro?
I'll destroy your pedophile.
Anyways, I will slap you so hard, you will wake up 2 weeks later, bro.
You're a dirty pedophile. I don't suppose you got a pedophile.
You're a waste man.
I suppose you got a little girl. You're a pedophile.
Anyways, you're a waste man.
You're a dirty pedophile.
So, this is what happens when you expose them. This is what happens.
You are exposing us?
Where's exposing?
You are exposing. You are Allah. You are exposing. You are
now.
Now.
You are exposing. You are Muhammad.
Where in the Quran does it say to kill innocent people? Men, women, children, and babies.
Allah
Let's
is
go to the book of Samuel.
Defender.
Show me.
Your Allah is a defender of Muhammad.
One second. Are you preaching or debating?
Your Allah is a defender of Muhammad.
This is how you debate.
There you go.
I said times. I told him time. Let's go.
Listen. Yeah, I'll be outside the park around 6:30.
I'm waiting for you to finish, bro. So
I'll be there 6:30, bro.
Let's do this.
I'll be there 6:30, bro.
Let's do this, pedophile, because I don't mind destroying you.
But listen.
6:30, bro. I'll see you there.
I'm waiting for him to finish.
Okay.
Yes, I am. He
changed the religion.
Oh my God, you look
okay, one second.
He was talking to me, bro.
So read it out, read it out.
Your cousin.
Read it out. He's reading out.
Ibn Abbas, the messenger of Allah, who changes his religion.
Wait a minute.
Okay, one second.
Him's going to ring me up.
It's not this in person.
I was
going to expose the prophet.
I said to you very clearly.
You have nothing to say about the pedophile prophet.
You are such a criminal, bro. You are a terrorist.
Okay, let's go to... Brothers, allow him, please, man. Let him talk. I've given you a time and a location. Enough.
I'm not victims.
Let me want. Bro, allow it. Bro, allow it, please.
You are... You preach your debate.
Come on.
Are you preaching your debate?
He is reading the hadith.
Okay, Exodus chapter 32.
Not yellow paper of Islam. Not yellow paper of Islam.
Say that again, Jew.
I ask you a question,
yes,
and you're going to the Bible to answer.
So if I... Okay, one second. If I say, for example, murder is bad and I'm a murderer, am I a hypocrite? Okay, that's why I'm going to the Bible.
So he can't answer.
Okay, so if he goes to the Bible, I'm going to show him 546.
Quran under the bus, he will throw his Allah under the bus,
and
he will throw his all knowledge under the bus. Under the bus, because
the Numbers chapter.
You're telling me, bro.
Torah, Zabur, and Anjil are from Allah.
Read them out. The book of Exodus.
And we call
the book of Exodus.
Son of Mary.
Come on.
Watch this.
Read.
The book of Exodus talks about killing a person.
Amen. Mary is a guardian. Confirming that which is killed for him.
Can I have my mic, please?
There you go. Every time you bring up the Bible, you get destroyed.
Anyway, the book of Exodus. In the book of Exodus. Check this out. In the book of Exodus, he asked me a question. He said in Bukhari, it says that you should. There's a capital punishment for an apostate. Yeah, this is an adult. Listen carefully. This is a capital punishment in an Islamic land carried out on an adult. Check this out now. Yeah, I know. Check this out. Your Bible says capital punishment for even children. bruv, you have to be careful. If you live in a glass house and you're watching David Hall's video, you're in trouble.
Allah gave us that Bible right there.
Watch this.
Allah's word and stuff, man. Watch this. People in the book and stuff.
Let me find it for you. Yeah?
With the people with the book. Yeah, I'm letting him.
For they said, make us gods who shall go before us. For those Moses, the man brought us.
Guys,
let any who have God go take it off. One second. One second. 32. Bro, leave that, leave that.
Forget Islam. Leave Islam.
Take off God and Mary.
No. Who says?
Who says that?
Who says that? Who says that? Show us the law. Show us the law.
Sorry guys, one second.
Maybe Muslims. Maybe Muslims are doing
here.
Let me show you. Let me show you Muslims are doing here.
Sorry, I'm trying to find the exact verse.
Let me show you Muslims are doing. Let me show you Muslims are doing.
Can someone find me the book of Exodus?
Let's talk about Christian pedophilia. Let's talk about that.
Let me show you. Let me show you here. Muslims are doing it.
Talk about the British.
Sorry, okay.
Muslims are doing it.
I'm trying.
Muslims are doing here.
One second.
Muslims are doing
the British
because they said we want to follow the Sunnah of the Prophet.
Well, I don't know.
This is the Sunnah of the Prophet.
In the Bible, when in the book of Exodus, in the book of Exodus,
you should be ashamed of the Sunnah.
Yeah, no problem.
You should be ashamed of the Sunnah.
I can do that, Jim.
You should be ashamed of the Sunnah. Because this Prophet is a pedophile.
Okay, listen. And he said to them, thus says the Lord God of Israel, put your sword on the side of each of you and go from the gate to gate throughout the camp, and each of you kill his brother and companion and his neighbor. And the sons of Levi did according to the word of Moses. And that day about 3,000 men of the people fell. And Moses said, today you have been ordained for the service of your Lord, each one of at the cost of the son of his brother, so that he might bestow a blessing upon this day. The next day Moses said to the people, you have sinned a great sin. Now I will go up to God and make ask him for forgiveness. Yeah? So one second. No problem. Do you condone? This is Jesus of the Old Testament. Jesus is asking for the killing of apostates. Not only men, women, children, anybody. One second. Tell me where in Islam does it say the capital punishment applies for children?
Aisha narrated in Bukhari.
No problem. The point is this. Jesus is ordering the killing of apostates. Children. Kids.
Shame on you.
That was what?
Shame on you by following this prophet.
He's going to follow.
You should be ashamed of this prophet.
Can we go to our team?
Come.
You think it's normal to come? The Bible.